she blinks, she talks, she bleeds, she can deliver a baby multiple ways. Victoria is an amazing high-fidelity simulator. We refer to her as our first patient because she has taught us about fetal medicine.
And having a model that is very authentic and lifelike is key. I can't overemphasize how valuable this has been in helping get us to the point that we are ready to take care of patients.
Today we simulated a condition called congenital diaphragmatic hernia, which is a hole in the diaphragm. They actually introduce a scope into the baby's trachea while the baby is still in the womb. They place a balloon to occlude the trachea so that we can allow their lungs to grow. Instead of a baby being born with very tiny lungs that are underdeveloped, you could have babies born with larger lungs that are more developed.
Really having that distinguished opportunity to be able to go into the uterus, into the womb, to start caring for those children so that we can change their trajectory of life.
We are on a relentless pursuit, not only to be able to offer the existing types of fetal interventions, but to develop new ones.
We have the benefit of a really robust research institute nestled next to us here. I think we're really poised to lead the field in fetal therapy.
We've hired some of the best surgeons in the world to perform this procedure. Our OR is one of the best. We have the largest neonatal network in the country, so outcomes will be better by having access, immediate access, to that care team.
It's exciting to finally get started.
We want to change the outcomes for babies that before now have not had hope for a positive outcome.
It's a privilege and an honor, and it's a blessing to be able to be part of that every day.